All right, we'll try this one more time. This is a quick pickups video for you guys. This is a pile of PS1, PS2, and PSP stuff. This is actually take six. I keep screwing up halfway through. Actually, I keep losing my voice for some reason, but anyway, here we go again. Found this one up to Value Village, basically a charity shop. $5.99, I believe it was. Way too much to spend on it, but I really do like the Red Alert games, the older ones, the Command & Conquer ones. And I've never seen this one before, so I picked it up. It's complete, it's mint, the case isn't even cracked. I checked up on eBay, and apparently they go for about $25 to $30, which is a bonus, although I probably won't get rid of it anytime soon. So I'll start playing that sometime next week, I guess. At the start of February, I found a couple jam packs for the PlayStation 1. This one is, what is that, Winter 2000. It's got some cool demos on it. Paid $1.99 for it, which I thought was a good price, but apparently that's all they sell for. Not that collectible, apparently. I thought they were. But I picked up this one also. And that one is Summer 2K. And these were both mint and had the instructions and everything. Another PS1 game here. This one is old school. Space Griffin VF9 by Atlas. The old long box PlayStation game. Paid $5 for this. Really good shape for something pretty old. It is complete. If I can get this open here for you. It is complete. And the disc is near mint. No problems with it. Show you some screenshots on it. So it just looks like really, really early PlayStation 1 graphics. So I'm looking forward to trying this one out. It does go for a few dollars on eBay, 20 to 30 complete. So yeah, happy to have that one. What else? PSP. A few dollar pickups for the PSP. Siphon Filter Dark Mirror. See, I keep screwing up halfway through the video, but anyway, I'll carry on. Dark Mirror, $1. And I found two copies of Wipeout Pulse, not $10, $1. Yeah, so I traded some of those in. Actually, those are older copies that I already had. PS2, Fight Night Round 3, that's complete, near mint. Rapala Bass Fishing, again, that is complete. There's some writing in the instructions, but I picked these up pretty cheap, so no big deal. Picked up a Japanese PlayStation 2 game. GPX Road to the Infinity. Not Road to Infinity, the Infinity. Second time I've actually owned this very same game. Graphics on it are really good. Really, really good. I'm not sure what the career mode or the Grand Prix mode is like. I haven't actually tried this one out yet, but yeah. And I'll be playing that on my brand new fat PlayStation 2. And it is modded. It has an old style mod chip, apparently. The type of mod chip where I have to put the game in, boot it up, turn the system off, and boot it up again. So that's cool. But I'll show you the model number. It's the, what is that, 3901. So yeah, I traded a few Pokemon games for this, so I'm happy about it. I didn't get any hookups with it, but I've got all those already, so that's cool. Happy to have that in the family now. I also picked up a really knockoff brand memory card. I don't have one of these, so that's cool. Yeah, thanks a lot, guys. Once again, this is just a really quick video. Show you some of the pickups I've had over the past few months. And I plan to put a couple more up this week, so check back. Thanks.